Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and whatever else is watching. My name is Nick, and this time I wanted to show something about the new DLC that came out actually over a month ago, almost a month ago, I think. Yeah, it's somewhere in September it came out. I'm not too sure. I've been just playing it to the end for way too much already. And I love this game, love this DLC. It is really good, and I wanted to show a little bit of this DLC to you. I've shown a little bit of the other stuff, so well, let's start a new game, shall we? Of course, we set it to normal. Okay, well, we start off with a attack. Yeah, I know. I've already played through this once, so yeah, I finished already this. I know. I already finished this DLC once because I just got way too caught up into it. Yeah, I know. And okay, this beginning has way too many tutorials if you already know what you're doing. Okay, you start off in a battle this time. Well, it's a battle with a blade and a driver. This is the DLC that actually takes place way before 500 years before. Yeah. That takes 500 years before Xenoblade Chronicles 2. So, okay, I know, I want to change. And I must say, well, this takes place 500 years before the game, and I must say, this DLC is actually better than the actual game. I actually like this a lot more, this DLC. It probably has to do the fact that how do I put this? I find Laura and Jin, the combination, a much more interesting set of characters than the. Then Rex and Pyra were, at least from the beginning. Maybe it's also because I've always wanted to see what they were all about, because they were frequent in the original game, mentioned and everything, but we never got any background from it. And I must say, it's really a lot better. In this battle, you can also see a lot of. You can also see a lot of. Changes already. To the battle system. It has to be. Well, it has to look like it's something older, something from a older era, with what isn't as sophisticated as It isn't as sophisticated as from the original game. However, I like this battle system a lot more than
Thank you, Jin.
Well,
okay, yeah, I really like the battle style a lot more in this. Also, something new, something that they added to this game. You have tips. You can reread your tutorials. You can just take a look at it all over again. Something that the original game did not have, something that just shows that the original game should have been released a lot later. they should have left it at least a year longer in development, because that's something I thought of the original game when I played it through it, even though it, well, it looked really good to my taste at the beginning and was appealing. It just, after a while, it really began to show how little actually was really finished about that game.
I think we've been spotted.
Because it's really needed a little bit longer in the cooker. Something about this battle system, you notice left, you don't no longer actually choose your blade. Actually, well, you get more blades later on. However, this is not, thank God, through the horrendous loot box system that they have implemented in the earlier game. So, actually, these game blades you get are actually how do we put this? They are, yeah. These are story sensitive blades. But yeah. And you get a ton of new stuff again. Well, the blades you get two blades to choose from. That's something. Each character has a maximum of two blades, and these blades are added to it through story, and not just through that loot box system that you have a random chance of getting a good blade. No. Ooh. And when I do this, you can do actually driver combos. Changing also does changing your vanguard, so putting your blade in front or your driver in front. It's also a special move, and it's really well done. I really like this bit. Because, yeah, first, well, you don't, aren't really... Okay, I get it, I'm still low level. These guys are coming after me like their next dinner, but it's pretty easy to defeat them now. That's something that they didn't really fix in this game. The aggression is... Ah, oh, crap. I missed that one.
Not bad, right?
Yes, indeed.
Snow blast.
Perfect sync.
Yeah. And the battle system is... Well, it's still... you choose by the face buttons which attack you use. Auto attack is still there. Which I actually like. That's one of the main goals. Main things about Xenoblade Chronicles that I really enjoyed, the auto attacking and how you're and that you're actually choosing your how do I say this, choosing your attacks, and this is really well done. Well, did I mention that I'm actually playing on the cartridge version of this DLC already? Yeah, there's an actual cartridge version, a standalone DLC. You don't have to buy, which is cheaper than the original game. So you don't have to buy the original game, actually. And this is so fine. Nice. This looks like a good spot to set up camp. Yeah, I'll start preparing the food. Oh, wow. Just starting. What do you reckon you'll make? Let's see now. I should be able to get my hands on the future. Okay. Well... Yeah, this is a little bit of story that you can go through yourself once you are actually going to play it. Also, you're seeing here team formation, also a little bit different, but still pretty much like in the original game. Except that we will pretty much through all out the end of the game drag along Mikael. And no, he will never be a playable character. Now we get collection points. Unfortunately, these things are still part of this game. Unfortunately.
This is becoming
I do prefer the original Xenoblade Chronicles and Xenoblade Chronicles X. Version of collection items, because frankly, walking up to these things and then trying to, you still have to walk around, it just takes a lot more time, especially because if you reach here, I have to press at least twice or three times the A button after I get the prompt in order to actually get something from it. These special, different colored collection spots. These are more likely to give up some, how do I say it? Some rare materials instead of treasure. I'm not allowed to go there just yet. Yeah. And it just takes a lot more time than just walking over them. Although an improvement is, since the beginning of the first game, is that they actually show what kind of thing you get. And you can also see what kind of material you get from it all. Oh man, this really looks bad, this village. That's just too bad about that all. Here you see that it is a tree, it's forestry and everything that works on that. Fresh vegetables!
This is becoming addictive.
But yeah, it still is a pain, and especially because just like, in battle I'm pretty much focused on other stuff and there is a lot more going on that I don't actually listen to the battle cries that they are doing.
Good work, everyone.
All the time.
I'm all adventured out.
However, here when you are collecting stuff, then you are really listening. There's nothing else to do, and then you hear the same voice over and over again, and that can become really repetitive. Another new thing is these campsites. In order to get pouch items, to get some rest, what usually was an inn, in villages and in cities in Xenoblade Chronicles 2, you no longer have those. There are still merchants around that can sell you stuff. However, you actually get better stuff by defeating enemies, finding treasure, and by making it all yourself. Yes, pouch items are some things that you actually need to, craft, like here. You have three things that you do at a campsite. First thing is, chat. You get a additional set of story. It's optional, but it's actually talking your characters talking over a campfire and just discussing of what just happened. In this case, it's after every story beat, after every pretty much story element, you get a new conversation. after every cutscene, I mean, is a pretty much a new conversation. And they just show a little bit more in-depth into the characters, which I really like, actually. And that's why I also like these campsites a little bit more. Your pouch items, on the other hand, and you can never miss one, because if you miss one, you can... Here, you have another one. You get more than one thing. You get more than just... You can catch up to them in all your conversations. Now I've caught up. So if I would select it again, I would get the same conversation as the last one. But here you are going to make pouch items.
Don't spoil your appetite before I'm done.
Like you see, these are your pouch items. And as you can see what the effects are, this is what you pretty much have to do. You have to sit at the camp and use your collection items to pretty much craft.
It came together nicely.
Craft your you have to craft it, your pouch items that you can then use to strengthen yourself. Yeah. Now that I crafted this, you have to go for pouch items. You have to craft them. You have another chat after I had another cutscene. You have to actually make them by finding items. Collection points, which makes those collection points far more valuable, far more you actually are more pushed towards getting those collection points and obtaining the items that were in there. However, it's also a little bit bad because, in the previous game you just bought the pouch items that you really wanted, that you're using a lot, and you're not dependent on a luck of the draw materials that you get from collection points. Although you can a little bit aim where you get some things, but the trouble is that you have to go back to that specific area where the collection point spawns actually the items that you need to get. And those collection points can be far away from any fast travel points, unlike in the previous game where the shops were much closer to fast travel points. If you choose rest, you actually get what was in the previous game, the inn. You can level up by providing bonus experience. However, I don't have additional bonus experience, so I can't actually I can go to one level higher. However, personally, in my playthrough of this game the first time, I never used this. You get pretty much, if you try to raise up your community and everything, that's something that will unlock later. Just by doing the side quests here, you pretty much level up consistently. You never really get into trouble with how much levels you actually need. It's pretty consistent in that sense. Okay, this is one thing that I really don't like, that they still not fixed this. And I don't think they are gonna fix this, because it is also a big brand mark of Xenoblade Chronicles 2. But every character has an affinity chart based on achievements.
Half the battle is living to fight another day.
And not only just achievements, each time you level up, you unlock something like this. You have to go into your menu towards the affinity chart of that character And then, well, only then you get the bonus that comes with that. It's not like something for you get the bonus as soon as you done the achievement. No, you have to cash in that achievement as well. Here again, defeat an Arlo Capiva in the secluded boneway in Torna. Well, 4 times. Well, you have to find that enemy and hope you actually will battle it, but you can also run past it. What is better is that you can actually use equipment. Here you have, you can put on core chips and auxiliary chips, which I don't have at the moment. And you can have also weapon arts. You can strength by putting weapon points. And as you can see, you will always never get more than you have here. So you will never have to choose between which arts will actually go onto your palette, actually. In all honesty. It's just these things. And you, well, pretty much level them up, especially equally. Vanguard arts are when you are in direct control of these characters. When they are on the front and not in the rear. The rear guard arts are actually the arts that are used when the blade or the character itself is in the back and delivering supports. These are also supporting arts. You also have the thin, the switch art. This art is executed when you switch a vanguard. So when the when I sent Laura to the back and Jin to the front. That's when Jin executes this. Laura has this as well. She also has vanguard and rear guard arts and a switch art. So once I send Jin to the back and Laura to the front, this art will be executed. And all that kind of stuff. But do we have accessories? Oh yeah, I completely forgot. Each character, human character, not Blade, the driver, also has its own weapon. And those weapons also have their elements. Even if you are now limited in which blades will be in your party, and actually all your blades that you receive throughout this game will always be in the party, and therefore you are dependent on those elements, you can still switch up your elements and your combos by providing the human characters with different weapons. Which is such a big improvement over the original game. And they really needed to have this in the original game, because that's such a big improvement. Even though it may seem limited to what you can do, there is so much more that you can actually get. Also here, item list, I don't really like what they did with the items here. They still haven't done a collectopedia stuff where you can get more information on where you obtained it or how do you obtain it, which area. Yeah, it says Kingdom of Torna. You can get it there. Or in Gormod. You can get it there. Yeah, well, guess what? It doesn't really say where or how you can obtain this kind of stuff. And that's so bad. It's really, I wish they did something better with that. I really don't like it, how they ditched the collectopedia. I've heard other people talk about that with Xenoblade Chronicles 2, they actually did away with all the conventions for the series. Like they did, which was pretty, in 2017, pretty much the buzzword for the Nintendo Switch games, that they did away with conventions like Zelda Breath of the Wild did, like Super Mario Odyssey did. Well, one thing to be said though, Xenoblade Chronicles didn't have any conventions. Xenoblade Chronicles was not... Well, the series doesn't have enough entries to actually set conventions. Xenoblade Chronicles X already diverted a lot from Xenoblade Chronicles, the original game. And Xenoblade Chronicles 2 actually diverted again from just as much from the Xenoblade Chronicles or Xenoblade Chronicles X series. What it actually did is the storytelling variety, it returned back to what that was. Actually setting a convention for a very linear story where you didn't really get chapters. Or chapters in the kinds of missions, and then actually all the side quests, actually the smaller, what usually be smaller side quest missions that you would require to be doing in Xenoblade Chronicles X before you can unlock a specific chapter again. Well, you have to, it's now just woven into the chapter in its entirety. And that's just going back to that convention. And that, however, there is not really a conventions to, well, to go back to, to say the least. So, spoiling for a fight. Okay, so yeah, in that sense, everyone is saying, I've heard a lot of times that they break with conventions, but no, they don't. They never had conventions to begin with. This is the third game in the series. And with Zelda and Mario, which are pretty much the poster child for breaking conventions on the Switch, the third game pretty much set the conventions. The suspense is killing me. There, the Link to the Past pretty much made the conventions of a top-down overworld view for 2D Zelda games. They went back to what was there. Mario, with Super Mario Bros. 3 pretty much set the platformer convention on that one. It's so, yeah, this is the third game. Although
this is becoming addictive,
I think, really think they should have put with Xenoblade Chronicles 2 some things a little bit longer in the unique monsters. Be careful with them. And because that's a unique monster, I'm not gonna fight that one. Because it's gonna hurt a lot. Especially because I'm still alone in the...
I think we've been spotted.
This can't really? I'm always the one that's getting aggroed, so... Yeah, and I must say, in this game, they actually really did things better. Well, the Collectopedia is still a little bit gone. However, hello?
Laura, let's switch.
Oh, brother. Yeah, I really like this game more, a little bit more. Even though, in the end, this game is a lot shorter. It's a whole lot shorter. Oh. I should have used the healing art. But then again, my problem would be that the medicine would end up on... Yeah, that's one thing I also... You can't jump through while you're... I'm... selecting. That's why I really come over here where we have a little bit more. You're not gonna come over here. Oh no.
Keep going. Don't lose the flow.
Okay, then run away. Are you coming over here? Good. Yeah, At least here I can jump.
Keep going. Don't lose the flow.
And when a potion drops, I can actually grab it. So
I feel you.
So I can, yeah, this is, you really have to choose your battlegrounds carefully in this sense.
Let's heal up. We're doing well.
Yes, this should do nicely.
Yeah.
This just isn't our day.
And really, I do like this game a lot, man. The battle system, the active battle system here that you have, that you can where positioning and surroundings actually play a part into everything. It's so cool. And with this, you also have. Hey, where did my potion land? Oh, there did my potion land. Oh, of course. Oh, I did not get enough time to get my potion. That's a little bit sad about this.
We'll avenge ourselves next time.
Yeah, I'm not really too good at this game.
This is becoming.
Come on.
I think we've been spotted.
Okay, follow me. Come over here, please. No? Hello? Then we lure it. Follow me! I do want to defeat you. Wait, where are you going? But I have to say, the story in here is also really good. Would you mind coming? Come over here, will ya? What are you stuck on?
Alright, follow my lead.
They'll live to regret this. Never again.
Your lifesaver.
Nope. A little bit too late.
I feel you.
I really have to say that. And this DLC, actually, it's a lot smaller. The story is a lot shorter. I think you can be done with this in, well, 20 to 50 hours or something. Somewhere in between it. It depends on how much you are doing. Well, how much you are actually. Well, how much you are actually dealing with the community. If you don't pay attention to that a little bit, well, you get a little bit tougher.
Pull back and pat aside, fight for my friends.
Yeah, you get a little bit of a tougher, how do we say this, enemies. Because you're not getting that much experience. However, you can go through the main story a lot faster. A whole lot faster. But if you do the community, then yeah, you can pretty much rack up to 50 hours or so before you can actually. I said a. Yeah, and then it's pretty quick. However, in Xenoblade Chronicles 2, I easily racked up to 200 hours or something. It's. That game is much longer, but then again, that game has a lot more titans. I think I know what I'm forgetting. I didn't put on my accessory, did I? I completely forgot about that. Oh, no, 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 no. At least I could reach that one. Yeah. Ooh.
Think you can keep up, Mora? Not bad, right? Snowblast.
Yeah. Although it's really, the original game had a lot more titans. Here you only have 1.5 titan. Yeah, you do get one titan. You actually have 2 titans. However, the one titan is from a previous game, and The... How do we say this? The... Oh, let me put on before I forget. Yeah. Oh, I did put it on. Ooh. Hey, wait, what? Oh, right. Right, I already had that one on. No matter. My bad. However, the... Yeah, how do you say this? The one Titan that is from the previous game, you only get half of the area that you had before that. So... Where was that? Oh, there is the treasure chest. The
suspense is killing me.
So, yeah, that's why I am actually saying 1.5 Titan, because... Yeah, it's less. Still. But they're making use of the area a lot better than they did before. Ooh. Key item thingy. Yeah, this one is to get to a secret area that I still didn't... Where you have to get a lot of these key item stuffs. Which I still don't have all of them. I still haven't found all of them. Still working through them on my other file. On my other save. Oh please, don't tell me that's from... Hey, level 9! Nice, but... I am gonna run. It's nice and all, but... Yeah. Being fought by two of them that are a higher level than you, then you're pretty much in trouble. Yeah. That's just pretty much a given. Okay. But yeah, the aggression here is also really, really bad. Still, the new Titan that you get is Torna, as you can pretty much have noticed already, and it's the Titan that we're actually working on at the moment. And I must say, it's a really awesome Titan. It has a very big diversity in its areas. Did I get something more? No.
Laura, let's switch. Not bad, right? Chill stroke.
Yeah, and it has a lot of diverse area. Just where we came from was really wooded. A wooden, a lot of wood in the area, and a lot of trees. However, this looks more like a beach. With lakes and all that kind of stuff. It's really interesting. This Torna Titan is really diverse in that sense. And we also get a lot more other types of areas. Which is really interesting. I really like that in this this game. Okay, remember the achievements? Yeah. Apparently we have to fight these. They aren't even going at us. They aren't even aggroing on us. We really have to go out of our way to kill four of these things to get that achievement. And I... Yeah.
Really, oh. My foot in it, haven't I?
Oh yeah, I remember. That one! I didn't pay attention.
Take them on a bit later.
We'll avenge this ourselves becoming next addictive. Time.
No, we're not taking them on a bit later. These are level 3 thingies. Although the level 6 one is probably somewhere around... Oh no, it's a level 5. Oh, he stops there, okay. Then we'll take them on one at a time. Nope. Not anymore. And it's just... It's... I really like this. Although you do need to have a bigger party though. People that can actually grab the aggro. That's... This is really... But that you can actually take control of the... Of the blades is something that I really, really appreciate. And Jin and Laura are just so interesting characters. Actually, all the characters in this game are so much more interesting. But what affinity did I succeed in? Oh, I just opened up another level. Yeah, I still have to do two of them. So, and because there are only two of them to be had in an area. Oh, come on! This is why I don't like those collection points. In the original game, you just run over them. But I'm already glad we don't have to deal with the loot box system here. No. Skip travel. Let's go back. Oh yeah, this is also really nice. I don't know if they did it in the original game. Well, they did it for if you were had a quest active, but you could always see you can see here where you on the map where there are new quests to be gained. Or maybe I had that turned off or something. That makes a little bit too many. Don't know what that deals. Here you can pretty much see what, yeah, what the map is like. Oh, I'm actually was going to use that to fast travel. Yeah, that's a little bit sad about the achievement system. You have to do that. These guys should be no problem. I won't. And if you don't do this, then your blades are pretty weak. They stay pretty weak. And well, that's something I also didn't really like about the Xenoblade Chronicles. Just well, how do we say this? Xenoblade Chronicles 2 is the last, the least interesting Xenoblade Chronicles of all three. That I have to be sure. Still, the game is a whole lot of fun. I really like playing through the story, and they have a great story. Oh, I wasn't paying attention to the health. I was just paying attention to something else. Well, who cares about... I'm not really going for the achievement now. Just continue on. And we will have to... Yeah, we get later. Because I also want to add something else, show something else. Because in this part, here we will get a new companion. And now we get to fight a gargoyle, one of the Aegis's artificers. However, if you look closely, you see a green Aegis Core Crystal, which means this is actually Mithra's Core Crystal and not Malus. I'm not too sure about whether this is actually counts as also is going to be Mithras or Malus? No, although Malus is the only one that controls gargoyles at the moment, I think. Which is really Oh, come on. Yeah, I'm kinda getting... kinda trying to... concentrate here and not to die, because this is a story important battle, and it would be really nice if I could get myself some leeway in the... Oh crap, I was a little bit late. This is gonna be fun. I can't wait until what's coming after this.
You need healing. I'm not talking to my friends.
Okay, we defeated the gargoyle, and that means...
This is no normal monster.
Not an Ardanian Titan weapon either.
Maybe it's Malice's.
Get down, you two!
Holy...
That was a close one.
Looks like Malos's artifices are still roaming around.
So it was.
Hey. Wait a minute.
The emblem of Torna.
You are Jin, right? Wow, I can't believe it. I came all the way out here, and who do I say but the paragon of Torna and his driver? You're so young. That core crystal was stolen 17 years ago. Quite a feat to pull off that heist at that age.
Are you going to arrest us? Execute us?
I don't know yet. I did just save you after all.
Oh, how magnanimous.
Laura, there's no point in talking.
Have it your way.
Okay, and we get to fight Adam and the Aegis. This is gonna be... This is just so awesome. That's so cool. Jin, you can do some things, you know. You don't have to wait. This is so awesome, really. I have to also say that, well, this is just the first fight on actually fighting these guys, and even though they are higher level, the game pretty much makes them pushovers, because they don't want you to actually lose against them. And it's really awesome. I have to say, Adam is also a so much more interesting kind of, well, character than Rex is, actually. Which is really interesting. Okay, let's see if I can get a level 4. Actually, I took them out before I could get a level 4. Okay. So be it.
Ah!
these two? They're just a driver and blade. Where's this strength coming from?
Well, he is the paragon of Torna.
Ah, I've had enough.
What? No. There's no need for you to...
You!
What?
Incredible! You! Both of you!
Huh?
That last attack, the force behind it was absurd. I'm amazed!
Oh, really? Well, that's just...
Oh, and passing the weapon. What a concept! How did you ever come up with that idea?
Oh, well... We were broke.
Uh-huh.
We couldn't afford meals, let alone another sword. And so we made do.
You're kidding. Oh, man, you guys are the best. I haven't laughed this hard in ages.
Huh?
I really, really like you two.
Master Adam! Sir!
Milton!
Oh, thank goodness you're all right. Master Adam, are you hurt at all?
Master Adam? You can't be the Adam Origo.
The Lord of Aletta. And fourth in line to the throne of Torna.
Oh, come on, Milton. I've been with him the whole time. You really think these two would cause any harm?
You've been using your dumb artifice again, haven't you?
Dumb?
So yeah, sure, nothing to worry about, right?
Milton? Who's this then?
Ah, this is Hayes. She rescued me from the jaws of some nasty monsters.
Well, I'd better give her my thanks.
Hayes!
Oh, was she with you?
I'm sorry to keep you waiting, my lady.
I see.
Yeah, from so this moment on, actually, I really like this story already better than the last one. Just this moment just proved already that the characters here are so much more enjoyable. Also Mithra is, well, and probably because she is just woken up and hadn't gone through the nasty business that kind of made her a downer in the Xenoblade 2. But she is more of a pubescent teenager in here.
So then, how come you've enlisted with a Baron?
And that's really, really awesome.
Freedom.
Really, I really like the characters in this. So and you get Hugo later on with Bridget and Aegeon. And they are so interesting. This band, it's smaller than what's in the Xenoblade Chronicles 2 in the the full game. However, this story is so much more interesting. It's so much more, well, how do I put it? How do I put this?
Views and ways to affect change.
I really like what they did with it. The characters are so interesting.
You don't see that every day.
And just the dynamic between everything is like you, so much better. Also, the personalities are a little bit more exaggerated than
lacking in compassion.
Huh?
Blades like you.
Yeah, how do we put this? Yeah, they are a little bit more exaggerated in their personalities. And just the moment where Lorna had to admit that they were broke and that's why they had to swap weapons. To take him away from me. That's really, really, really funny moment was that. You didn't see that one. I didn't see that one coming. To subdue especially mass, because seek out lost trinkets. Yeah. Who cares about paragons anyway? I have to say, it's really beautiful, this game. The DLC is even more worth it, even though shorter than the original game, Xenoblade Chronicles 2. If you have to choose between one of the two, I truly recommend putting Xenoblade Chronicles 2. And I don't know what it would be like to experience this story without knowing the story of Xenoblade Chronicles 2. Because there are moments of recognition. Moments that I saw, hey, yeah, this was in this flashback scene of Xenoblade Chronicles 2. Oh, this was in there. This was in there. And it's something recognizable in that sense. However, I do think that you don't need to know anything about Xenoblade Chronicles 2, the original story, to actually be able to appreciate this, this story. It's truly a story on its own.
Me?
So
you meant you're unpolished.
And I really like that.
You lose your memories.
The areas are beautiful. Experience with people. Gradually, the nature of the characters are interesting. The combat system is really well refined in this sense. And you have this blade combo that you can do, which is based on elements. In the original game, the blade combo is limited to the unique chains, and which is no longer a sense in this game. The unique chains give a special buff, more damage and everything, if you can find them. However, if you put any three elements after one another, they are still counted as a blade combo. A level 1, level 2, level 3 combos and all that kind of stuff. About this whole Malos thing. And that's what I really like. This
whatever happens, I'll protect you.
Battle system, how sure. much more limited it is therefore also much more refined.
What's happening?
And that's so beautiful. And but even though this world is smaller than the original one,
but what?
It still is so much more richer. For it.
Please say.
And so I really, really enjoyed playing through this DLC. I can really recommend getting this. It was just so nice. Even though they still haven't really, well, we probably need to go to Xenoblade Chronicles 3 before they
Your Highness
fix anything from that.
What is it?
The going
although, thing. One thing I have to say, these cutscenes, they can go on pretty long. Yes. Yeah. Sometimes you wish.
You see,
I think my
Lady Laura seeks the whereabouts of her mother.
If I would not move the poke or something, or the left thumbstick, often go out and conduct these searches myself. And
I see. Then
how do we know? Yeah, then I think the controller would fall asleep.
Happened yesterday. I did not have the opportunity to
so,
say.
Yeah.
My lady, your mother is currently residing in a small hamlet called Torigoth.
Small hamlet.
Torigoth.
That's on the edge of Gormot. Ardanian and Sian forces clash out there frequently. It's very dangerous.
Indeed. Yeah.
The cutscenes can sometimes go along and go long, but no they are really waste. Beautiful, still fun to watch. Even though it can put my controller to sleep.
And then you will get a little bit faded screen.
Of course, but...
But the story just is beautiful.
Then let's go. Malos hasn't hit that part of the world yet.
And I think this is also where I'm gonna leave it off.
Find him there.
Exactly.
I really have to say... Yeah, this is the end of the gameplay that I'm gonna show.
And you go to Torrigoth.
I thank you all for watching. I am actually curious what you think about this game and what you thought about this video. What you've seen about Xenoblade.
That's the general
idea. What you like about this series. Leave those thoughts in the comments below. For the rest, I thank you all for watching, and I hope to see you again next time.
Princely behavior.
Bye!
You think this is bad? Just stick around for a bit.
Nobody's, like, making you come along, you know.
Really, Mithra?
Unfortunately, your cynicism is... Body and soul.
Your cynicism is really one thing in this. You are truly a puber. In puberty in here. I would say grow up. But on the other hand.
Still,
he's kind of more interesting like that.
It makes sense to stick together.